We have to decide when you're, once you've decided on your fingering, you have to decide about the let go, how fast you're going to let go. Okay, so, and as I said before, you have here staccato, rotation, and the walking hand and arm. All three are working here. So I'm going to play it without the pedal so you can hear the let go. Now, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm trying on the way down. I have to get here before I can play it, so I won't slam into it. So that's a very fast, there's a fast staccato, as we said, on the way up. And a fast staccato here, so I can start again at the bottom. I start on the bottom. Okay? Now you might say, I don't know if you, can you see the rotation that I'm doing here? It's toward the thumb, and I go over the thumb. But if I do too much of it, do you see it's, it kind of throws the whole thing off. There's not too much rotation that you can see when you come from an octave to a single note like this. I know that I'm balancing toward the thumb and I'm going over my thumb, but that's about it, okay? We'll see later when we go from a single note, you'll see a different amount of rotation. So an important thing to know is that when you combine different elements, like here we're combining the rotation and the staccato and the walking hand and arm, it's not always met, the amounts of each are not always the same. So even though they're in the same piece, they're in a left hand arpeggiated accompanying pattern, this legato, the amounts of the walking hand and arm rotation and staccato can be different, okay? So you always have to look for the differences to make sure everything works well.